Okay, so
we are going to start with periodic classification in three levels. The two will go simultaneously and third will we will take after completion of the chapter. This is CBSC plus part. And then the probable questions for IIT. When we talk about periodic classification, the first question comes in our mind that why periodic classification is required.
आखिर क्या जरूरत है पीरियोडिक क्लासिफिकेशन की? एनीबडी हैज एन आइडिया?
एज द नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स आर देयर सो स्टडीइंग इंडिविजुअली ईच एलिमेंट इज अ हेक्टिक जॉब टू आइडेंटिफाई दिस एंड टू कोरिलेट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एलिमेंट्स each other and to group them in one type, periodic classification was required. Now we come to the first classification ever for element. First classification.
Is that a part of
the first classification ever for elements was done by Bergelius. Now he said that the elements are of two types. One is metal and another is non-metal. Now this metal and non-metal is based upon five characteristic properties: lustre, malleability, ductility, sonorosity, and conductivity. The element those present these properties, they are under metal and they do not have non-metal. But there are certain elements or one or two elements which may possess either of the property of these five
metal.
And they are commonly known to be pseudo-metal. Pseudo-metal. And one of the important pseudo-metal or most important pseudo-metal is iodine. Then question comes, which metallic property is found in iodine? Iodine is a non-metal belonging to halogens, but which metallic property? So the first metallic property, that is metallic luster, is found in iodine. Then let's come one by one. What is luster? What is malleability, ductility, sonorosity, and conductivity? Metallic luster is the property by which metal shines. Then question comes, many things shine. When we polish our shoe, it shines. Glasses are shines. This is a shine of mirage. Many shines are there. But what is the difference between these two shines? So the other shinings are because of reflection of light, and this is because of continuous emission and absorption of energy from the environment by the valence electron and then gets reflected to our eyes. That means if something, for example, a diamond to be shined, light will come, go inside, get the total internal reflection, and then the shining occurs. But for metals, it can shine in the dark also. We are keeping a metal in the dark. There also, it will absorb energy, release energy, and that comes to our eyes and gets reflected, and we gets a shine. Then we have malleability. We tend to form sheets. Ductility, stretch to form long thin wires. Sonorosity, when we hit a metal, it produces different type of sound known as tong sound. And then we have a conductivity. Now conductivity for many things are there, but that conductivity again differs. Sonorosity of spatial sound is many. Same way ductility, we can make a wires of plastic, we can make a wires of PVC.
So many types of wires are there, but what is the difference between these two, ductility and same way malleability? We tend to form sheets. First, malleability, we tend to form sheet because of large interatomic space within an atom. Ductility, metals can be drawn into long thin wires because of long range or wide range kernel force. Sonorosity, when we hit a metal, valence electron goes within the interatomic space and then produces echo. Conductivity, it is a special type of property of conduction by virtue of zero energy barrier between forbidden gap and zero energy barrier between conduction band and valence band, which is commonly known as forbidden gap.